FactsVerse presents. Experts that crack a 1,500-year-old puzzle are left with one wild realization. If you pick up a history textbook, you'll see we think we have most of our past figured out. That may not be as cut and dry, though, as we're led to believe. There are archaeological digs going on all the time, and we're finding new things that prove that we used to think was true may not have been true at all. In fact, in 2019 this happened when a historian discovered a single artifact. It all began when a group of archaeologists was searching the Caesarea Maritima. It's an ancient amphitheater located in Israel. It's one of the best-preserved Roman sites in the area. It was built in 22 BC by King Herod. The amphitheater was a cultural hub for hundreds of years, and recently it's been determined that the amphitheater was used for very dark purposes, not just concerts and plays. During the 50s, a team of researchers excavated in the theater, and during their search they turned up some pretty exciting things. Many of the relics found gave the researchers a better idea of what Roman life was like back then. During the search, they came across something that had the archaeologists baffled, though. It was a lead tablet that contained Greek lettering. In the 1950s, the translators were unable to read it. Over time, it had become eroded, leaving the message illegible. Because nobody could read the tablet, it was put into storage for close to 70 years. The tablet would have remained forgotten in storage if it weren't for a professor named Attilio Mastrosinca. He believed that he could succeed where others had failed, so he visited the Archaeological Museum of Milan. That was where the tablet was being stored. When he went to the museum, he brought along a piece of cutting-edge technology, and he promised he would be able to read the text. He was hoping the text would include something interesting, too. The Italian professor was sure that reflectance transformation imaging could help decipher the text. The method involves taking lots of photos of an object from all different angles using different lighting. It's said to be able to reveal markings that are invisible to the naked eye. Professor Mastrosinca was thrilled when he was able to see the barely visible inscription. It was the first time in thousands of years that the ancient message was visible. Now the professor got past the first hurdle of making the letters visible. He still had to translate the tablet. Translating it wasn't easy either, but the professor refused to give up. It took a while, and soon he learned it was no ordinary message. The text was 110 lines, and he went through each line one by one. The text in the tablet called out for many horrifying and captivating events to unfold. According to the text, it was all because of a dancer named Manna. Based on where the tablet was found, it's believed that Manna performed at the theater. The tablet had text that expressed the desire to bind down the dancer and make him bent and unseemly. It didn't take long for the professor to realize that the text on the tablet was actually a curse. The tablet asked the demons of the sky, the demons of the air, the demons of the earth, underworld demons, demons of the sea or the rivers, and demons of the spring to strike Manna down. The text also asked that Thoth, the ibis-headed Egyptian god of judgment, step in. This surprised the professor because the tablet was dated to 500 AD. The professor was surprised by what was written in the text because by that point Christianity was the predominant religion across the Roman Empire and beyond. The fact that the author of the text was invoking the magical gods because of contempt for Manna was shocking, and the professor wanted to know why. The professor had a theory about the reason for such contempt. Many of the dances that took place in the theater were more than easygoing performances. They were also competitions between rival factions. Manna's performance could have had massive political implications. The professor believed that the person who wrote the tablet believed that their survival depended on taking down Manna by any means necessary. The professor hopes that digging deeper into the theater will uncover more clues, and maybe even a record of Manna's fateful performance. He believes that's the only way to learn more about the dancer and what he did to make the author of the tablet so angry. It's amazing people were still relying on curses at a time when Christianity was said to have taken over. Only time will tell if the professor will find the next piece of the puzzle. Subscribe for more.